A very warm good afternoon to one and all. I am Harika. This is my team, Pranav, Ajay and Aruna. We are from Community Recommendation of Fundamental Research Group. Water, water everywhere, but not a drop to drink. Analogous to this, data, data everywhere, but not a thought to think. In order to facilitate the user with a set of recommendations, like in order to avoid the problem of finding what article can be read, which article can be read by for an user, we come up with a recommendation system. In real life, we often ask our friends or our peers to recommend us in order to get more content or more data about one particular article or one particular thing or any kind of book to be read or any kind of references. So a good recommendation system should help the users to get the data in such a way that they are interested in. Our problem definition is we have M users and N articles. And we have some ratings associated with user and item pace. Optionally, we have the timestamps. So the recommendation system should output the list of N recommendations for the user. Those N recommendations are the topmost recommendations for the corresponding user's interest. And we have some technologies used. Those are Flask, Mat, Platlog, NumPy and Pandas, Redis, SciPy, SH and TensorFlow. And there are mainly two major approaches for building recommendation system. Those are content filtering and collaborative filtering. Content filtering is mainly concern about the user and the item in such a way that we can use the metadata. Like for example, if a user is interested in the machine learning article published by some particular XYZ author, then we will recommend some more of the machine learning articles that those are published by the same author itself. And coming to collaborative filtering, we don't need any domain knowledge. We will look at the past user item interactions and we will find the similar users can be found. Then the set of articles recommended for the other users will be recommended to the current user also. We followed the methodology of collaborative filtering with matrix factorization. It can be explained by Pranav.
Okay, so as she said, we basically follow collaborative filtering. And again, collaborative filtering can be divided into two methods. So one is neighborhood based, in where you sort of try and define similar users. And if I want recommendations for you, I will look at users who are similar in some sense to you and generate recommendations based on that. So this involves the cosine similarity and things that some other team used. But the model that we preferred is called the latent factors model. So in this case, we basically take the three-dimensional data set that we have, which consists of the users, the articles, and the ratings the users have given to those articles. And we convert this into a 10-odd dimensional data set. So you can think of this as the inverse of principal component analysis. Instead of trying to reduce the dimensionality of data, you are expanding the dimensions. And you hope that these extra dimensions will help you explain the ratings. And like in content filtering, you build up huge user profiles where you take care of demographic information about the users, their tastes, and other things. So these factors that we generate, these are somewhat analogous to this. But in content filtering, you have to manually sit and generate factors, which is almost impossible for large communities. That's why we settled on this computer-generated factor model. And so the model we are using latent factors, and it's implemented through, there are many approaches, but again, the most popular one involves matrix factorization. And the basic idea is you have this huge matrix, which consists of users and items, and the entries of the matrix are the ratings that the user has given that item. And our problem is, like in SVD, where you want to split a matrix up into, basically you want to factorize the matrix, but over here we do not impose any orthogonality constraint. We are just happy to get two different factorizations of the matrix. Our approach is almost exactly similar to the one used by the tagging team, except that our model differs only very slightly in that we also allow negative entries in our factorized matrices, while they constrain themselves to positive entries. So how it works is you have this huge matrix I was talking about. You split it into two smaller matrices, U and V. So in U, you will have U as number of users times number of factors. Factors can be things like, is this a comedy movie or is this a crime movie? So if you have that sort of factor, then positive values will indicate that it's a comedy movie, and positive values for that factor in the user matrix will indicate the user likes comedy movies. And similarly, in the item matrix, you will have if it's a comedy versus crime factor, and positive values will indicate that it's a good comedy movie, negative values will indicate it's a good crime movie. This is, we ran this matrix factorization model on an Amazon Music data set. These green values you can see over here, they represent items that were purchased by the user and then the user reviewed these items. These blue items over here are the items our model is predicting the user will like, and these red items are the ones that our model is predicting the user won't like. So you can see that there's this one lonely two over here, so all the low ratings go to the right of the two, and there's a lot of 5, 5, there's 1, 4 over here. All the positive ratings are clustered near these positive values. And this I'll be covered. Okay, so there's one problem still with this naive matrix factorization model. The problem is that users are humans, they are not perfect machines. Sometimes they'll be having a bad day, so they'll give low ratings to every article. Or maybe there is some article suppose it's written by a very popular author, so the ratings for that article will be biased upwards than what it should be. And that's not the only problem that we might face. You can have biases that are changing with time. So you can have the classic example given over here is someone who watches psychological thrillers. Such a person could very well start watching crime movies next year. And also, we also have sharp transient shocks to user preferences. So things like there might be seasonal variation. So you have the World Cup going on right now. And so we might expect to see football-related articles getting a lot of views. None of this stuff is covered by a naive matrix factorization model. So we implemented a new model that tries to capture these time variations. How we work is we take our time period, which say consists of 60 days, and we divide it into equally sized time periods. So we'll split them to periods of 5 days each. And then you look at how preferences change from 1 5-day period to another 5-day period. And because it's any transient shock should average themselves out, you'll only get the long run component of any drift in user bias. And then to address what I was saying, like the user is having a bad day or something, then we look at each day within that time period and we introduce a variable that soaks up all the variation in ratings for that day. This model is known as Time SCD++. So this is one of the best, this model gives you the best possible results you can get on a data set out of all the recommendation algorithms that exist. And this is a comparison. The blue bars are the naive matrix factorization model I was talking about. And this orange bars is the time model. So one is the Netflix price data set. This is a data set that contains about 100 million ratings. And this was the data set that started the entire recommendation contest everywhere. And there's both the Time SAD model and the matrix factorization model were initially tested and developed for a Netflix price data set. Then there's the Amazon digital music data set, which again you can see in both of these data sets, the Time SAD model performs much better than the naive matrix factorization model. And this is one book's data set, which we also include for comparison purposes, but there were no timestamps given for the book's data set, so we could not train our time-based model on this data set. And now Aruna will talk about the workflow.
This is the workflow of recommendation system. Our recommendation system runs separately from the main collaborative community system. And all interactions between the collaborative system and recommendation system done through the post and get request. First, the post request sent to the ready server. Post request contains the JSON data which is collected from the event logging system, and this data is given to the RS server. It starts training as a sub process. Why we need as a sub process? Because if we run as a main process while training, we didn't get any predictions. So if we run as a sub process, we can get the predictions while training also. After training the system, the model will be saved in a ready server as for the future reference. Workflow: when user visits an article, the CC collaborative community makes a get request to the ready server, and ready server access through the get request, ready server access the saved model, which is saved in ready server, that will be used for training predictions. RA server returns the recommendations, predictions, those are made by saved model, and CC. Finally, collaborative community displays the recommendations through the API to the user. The next part will be continued by Ajay.
For recommendation system, we are using two APIs. One is Django API, another one is Flask API. Django API is in the collaborating system. It is take the username as the input, and it will put a get request to the Flask API, and the predictions are done in by Flask API, and finally Flask API return the top rated article recommended for a user IDs. It will give to the Django API, and the Django API will collect the corresponding article titles, and Django API return to the front end page along with IDs with the titles also. This is for front end design for authenticated users, and this is for anonymous users. So our future work is, presently we work on article views, and we need to integrate the upload and download and social media also, and more efficient utilizations of memory and parallelization of time is needed. These are the device notes. These are the reference. Thank you.
So what are the parameters for recommending an article?
Collaborative communities.
So, article views, how that can be a parameter for recommending other article?
Because if I know you viewed an article, then that, like, you don't just randomly go and view articles. You look at the title. If the title looks interesting, only then will you view the article. So, even just a view tells us something about what sort of article you might like.
Okay. So, okay, can you go to that demo page? So go just two page back. Yeah, this one. So okay, I am reading cloud computing.
Yeah.
How and why will I read data structure?
So
or DBMS, computer network.
So we just randomly generated some articles. I mean, we didn't generate a huge data set of articles.
Okay, I see. So aren't you considering tags?
Well, we don't want to consider tags, because supposing you're reading articles on maps, then it is plausible that you might be interested in CS articles too, or you might be interested in biology articles too. So if you just look at tags, then you run into two problems. One, you'll miss out on these sorts of comparisons, and then you're depending on someone to actually make tags in a reasoned and well-behaved fashion.
So you see the importance of Rekha Mem's system here. Ontology will help in making the system better. And so it is, as Fatak sir mentioned, personalized material should be the next big thing actually.
Yeah,
we
so
are focusing
we
on
cover
that.
That in that. So in our factorization, so the, when we split it up into a user matrix, we have a separate row for every user.
So before you go into the detail, yeah. So let me tell you one thing. So if you want to recommend something to me, personally, you can't do that unless you know me.
Yeah.
Correct.
Yeah.
So your system is not trying to know the user.
Yes.
Correct. So these are very good. Okay. But parameters are not there. So do you know what's his or her age?
No.
Male or female?
No, we are not.
What is exploring otherwise? Okay. There are many parameters that should be considered, at least the education. Okay, yes, so that you can decide the level of articles to recommend. So, okay, so when somebody is on a machine learning page, there's no point in talking about data structure. It's kind of very basic thing for the one who is reading about machine learning.
Right.
Yeah.
So and
time
yes.
Time is spent on each field, each article.
And
it will be okay whether I have gone through it or it is just by chance I
yeah.
opened.
And I will recommend so not only just like dislike, but the system that my mentors had developed, the interns had developed, it will be a good thing. So by saying it's easy, difficult, or boring, confusing, so it will help in identifying more personal articles for the person. Thank you.
So you have used a combination of collaborative filtering and matrix factorization,
no,
right?
Matrix factorization is sub technique in collaborative filtering. So we have used matrix.
Okay, so you have not used the neighborhood based methods.
No.
No. Okay, so just a doubt actually, based on neighborhood based methods, you
yeah.
have two, either based on content or based on
users,
users
yeah.
right? So in content, like the example that is given based on movies,
yeah.
so it makes sense to cluster some movies based on the parameters like
yeah.
The director or just whatever what you have mentioned.
Yeah.
Whereas based on user, how do you cluster? Because once you have some clusters, then it makes sense. But when you don't have any user, it's like, When does a new user get added to a cluster?
So, like, if you have a completely new user, then you're right. We don't know anything about the user. So we just assume that it's an average user. But supposing you have a user who's viewing mainly computer science articles, then you can cluster that user along with other people who are viewing computer science articles like that.
So, oh, so still, so that means you will be using some information provided by the user, just like...
No, the user doesn't provide any information. We just look at the articles the user is viewing. So
okay.
if you and I view mainly the same same articles,
mm-hmm.
then we are in the same cluster. If there's no overlap between the articles we have viewed, then we are in different clusters.
Okay, so isn't that cluster neighborhood-based method based on content?
Yeah, but there's a slight difference. In neighborhood-based models, you have to give the dimension on which you are building your neighborhood explicitly.
Mm-hmm.
So you might have some tag that calls it a computer science article or a maths article.
Mm-hmm.
Over here, we are learning the dimension automatically.
Mm-hmm.
So we do not have any tags or what sort of articles they are. So we are even inferring the article type automatically.
Okay. Yeah, fine. And yeah, just one more thing. So you also mentioned TensorFlow at some point.
Yeah.
So have you actually implemented?
Yes.
So
we have two methods.
Mm-hmm.
One was the time method. That's not yet been implemented in TensorFlow. That
mm-hmm.
was a future work. Parallelize that using TensorFlow.
Mm-hmm.
But the other one, naive matrix factorization, that has been implemented using TensorFlow.
So you actually used it. What
yeah.
is the GPU used?
We did not have a GPU, so we just used a CPU-based version of TensorFlow.
Okay. Yeah, just one more. The data sets that you have mentioned,
yeah.
So the graph that you have mentioned,
yeah.
So is this the result of your own experiment?
Yeah, our own experiment.
So how did you manage to get the data set of Amazon and Netflix?
So that's in a reference. So Amazon data set is from, I think, reference number 8 and 9. There were these people, they scraped all of Amazon, and now they have uploaded the data set on the website characterized by these are music reviews,
okay.
these are automobile reviews, things like that.
Sure. Good. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.